जय श्री माता जी एवरीवन, लेट्स हम्बली बाउ डाउन सीकिंग श्री माता जी परमिशन फॉर दिस मॉर्निंग्स मेडिटेशन। हम्बली रिक्वेस्टिंग दैट शी एक्सेप्ट आवर सरेंडर। And to please let the power of Sri Viratangana enlighten my brain. Raise our kundalinis, put ourselves in a bandhan, and settle down in meditation, working on our left vishuddhi with our right hand on our left vishuddhi. Father, as I am the Spirit, by your grace, how can I be guilty? Mother, please dissolve the habit of mental judgment and guilty feeling within me. Give me the strength to face my actions and correct myself so that the collective consciousness is awakened and established within me. Mother, I am the spirit. I am not guilty. Continue keeping our attention on the left Vishuddhi and listen to Sri Vishnumaya Puja from New York, 1987.
Today we have assembled here to do the puja of Vishnumaya. Vishnumaya is created through human effort also. As you see, the clouds, when they rub against each other, then the electricity is created. So first the clouds have to be created. Perhaps on the sea. See how many chakras come into play. Sea is the void and the sun acts on the sea. Also the moon acts on the sea. As a result of that, clouds are created. This electricity is not created in the ocean. That would create problems. Is created in the sky so that everybody can see it, can hear it. They see it first and hear it later. It's all well organized well calculated. That is Vishnumaya. But it was created also with some understanding by human beings on this earth. First of all, they saw the two clouds rubbing each other. So in the primitive stage, human beings tried to rub two material things to create electricity. So two material things, that is two parts of matter, when rubbed, created the electricity. It's very significant to see. Matter can be used to create electricity. The spark of the electricity comes from the matter. Without matter, they could not have started cooking the food. So how it has helped the void? First, from the ocean, it went into the sky, gave the message to the people to create the electricity. See the love. Then people learned how to cook the food for the digestion to be easier for human beings. How it comes back? From nature, how human beings learn and do it for the good, betterment, hita of human beings. This benevolent energy, which was meant for the benevolence of human beings, again was utilized. As you see, this is the creation, all this is of Vishnu Maya. That's why it's a Maya. With electricity, you can create a Maya. You know that very well, how you can create it. So many are here, luckily, in such a spontaneous way, so many who are dealing with this electricity in creating Maya. America is so much helped by this electricity, by Vishnu Maya. You are not thankful to it. Like you have got Niagara Falls, you have so many falls here. Again the water, when it falls, it's come from water. When the water falls on the lower level, very lower level, then it moves the turbine and those movements can create electricity. So you have hydrostatic electricity. Also, the electricity is produced, as you know, through coal. Now here, again, the Mother Earth works out for the betterment of human beings, create the coal in her being. I think she must be taking all the badhas, absorbing all of them in her stomach, and must be burning the stones inside her to make the coal. And then that coal is used for making electricity. How much the nature is working for our betterment. Your New York would not have been there but for electricity. It stopped for 15 minutes and you know, knew the power of electricity. You cannot move without it. You cannot exist without it. That's why it had to be used and created, given you so much of benevolence. You cook with it, you see with it, you listen with it, you enjoy with it. You wouldn't have your televisions, you wouldn't have anything without electricity. You won't even have these exits here written. You would have walked into the walls. So much of this Vishnu Maya has worked, but she is a Maya. She can create a Maya. And this has created a big Maya in the minds of human beings, that we are on top of the world. You are not. If electricity recedes from you, you'll become again the same primitive people making electricity out of rubbing the stones. take it from. This flow of electricity is available to you for your good and not for your destruction. But what has happened today is that using this electricity for your destruction. I remember about, say, 30, 40 years back, or even earlier, when we saw the films, they were not colored films, American films, were beautiful films with substance in it. They wouldn't show one married man running after another married woman. None of these stories. Very pure form of beautiful family life. Everything nourishing was shown. We don't hear of any such thing where they showed evil winning over. Now you find they show a thief, and the thief becomes the hero. Then the people see those films, and the children especially I've seen have that thief as the symbol of something great. So they are going against the void completely, against the religion that is within us. Absolutely. The thing that was to nourish the void, the one that was to sustain you in your valencies, is now disturbing the void completely. That's the Maya part of it, the same electricity which was to give you the right path, the light in the darkness, is now sucking you in like a magnet towards your destruction. This is the Vishnu Maya who came to this country in such a big way and then spread all over, has given ideas to everyone. People picked up all your techniques, all your styles. You have Hollywood and all these very famous people here who have thrived on this electricity. But without thanking the Vishnu Maya, they started doing things which were against Vishnu Maya. This Vishnu Maya is the one who has helped you because she is the sister of Sri Krishna. And because this is the domain of Sri Krishna, she came down here to help you. Now she's the sister, this must be understood very well. Now sisterly relation is a pure relationship. Now of course everything is so confused, but that's the purest relationship between the brother and the sister. The brother is protected by a sister. And the sister's chastity is looked after by the brother. A brother who doesn't feel hurt if his sister chastity is in danger or she plays about with her chastity, he is not a brother. He is not a brother anymore. He is responsible to see that his sister keeps her chastity. Only her chastity can protect him. It's a mutual working. This feeling, if it does not develop, that she is my sister and that I have to look after her chastity, for that I have to behave myself well, so that she doesn't find faults with me. It's such a cleansing process this relationship has, as much as the electricity has the cleansing process for you. Every way what the electricity does, a sister does for her brother. She cooks for him, she tells him the right path, she enlightens him and sometimes shocks him also. They have to have certain shocks, otherwise they will not know how to work it out. And the best of all, she's the one for whom you have to be very careful to know the technique how to handle your sister. If you do not know how to handle your sister, you can be absolutely wrong and you may get it, something that you would never expect to get. So one must understand how to handle a system. In this case, we have to know that the same was born again at the time of Shri Krishna as Draupadi. She took her birth as Draupadi. And when Draupadi was attacked by the Kauravas, they wanted to remove her sari. To remove the sari itself is a symbol that they challenged her chastity. Now, if you see in the Mayanagari, women have no sense at all that they should cover this part of their body. In this Mayanagari, the other way around, when I heard a very responsible person saying that in our culture women must expose their body. What is this culture? It's anti-Krishna, completely anti-Vishnumaya. Such people will get into trouble, I'm sure, with electrical problems. The brothers who do not bother about the chastity of the husband of their sister and also support him and asking to do wrong things, hide his things, are also equally responsible. Like in Sahaja Yoga, you know that a sister is to be protected, and the sister husband, if he is doing anything wrong, he is to be told off by the brother. Like once in India, one newspaper passed some remarks about me. My brothers were up in arms. I thought, now it's going to be terrible. How am I to manage it? It was a big problem. They were going to go to the courts. When I told them, I'll not go to the courts, or I don't go, but we'll go. They told my husband also. My husband and my brothers put together was formidable. I didn't know what to do. I wrote to one Sahaja Yogi that go and see the editor of the newspaper, tell him that these are my brothers, be careful. They are very powerful people in India, and from here my husband is terrible, but they would not apologize. So I thought of another Vishnumaya, that there was a big strike and the paper was closed for exactly 6 months, and they had to go in for a big, very big losses. And when they started, the people who were working there came back and said that, why did you write against Sri Mataji? We are not going to come back. And they had to apologize. So how the brother's love can compel even Adi Shakti to do things that she would not normally do? In the same way, when Draupadi was challenged, Sri Krishna was not in Hastinapur, where it had happened. He was more than a thousand miles away from that place. But said that, Shankha Chakra Gada Padma Garudalai Siddhare. He came on his condor with all his weapons, Shankha Chakra Gada Padma. All these he brought to save the chastity of his sister. There are many incidents in our history. I don't know if I can cite anything in your history. But I would say, when I see Abraham Lincoln, I think he was a great brother to the Statue of Liberty. The way he fought for women in such pure love and without taking any money, without charging them anything, to punish the husbands who were drunkards. That's just like a very good, powerful brother to behave. But those feelings are now dying out, I think. But say in Russia, when I went to see Lenin's house, and throughout, apart from his wife, was his sister, who helped him to type for him, to do all his official work. He has written volumes and volumes of books in that small age of 54 years, volumes. First of all, he was in Siberia. And just imagine, this sister of his has typed most of it. Throughout in the whole tour, we felt the presence of the sister and the way she has helped her brother. This relationship is so pure, which doesn't want anything. A wife may say that if you don't meet a court, I'll divorce you. May in England, possibly in America, they say so. But a sister cannot divorce. She cannot divorce it. This time in the newspaper, they published the name of my brother. So I said, what can I do? He's my brother. So he's my brother. Good, bad, anything. He's my brother. I cannot divorce him. It's something, a relationship which you cannot break. Nature has given you this relationship. But when you come to the collective, it's very important that we must respect this relationship. If you do not respect this relationship, you cannot work out collectively. Like in a party I go and I feel something very funny happening. Somebody's wife is entangled with somebody's husband. All sorts of funny things happen. But in collective, if you know, except for my wife, the rest of them are my sisters. The purity settles in like that. You don't have to worry. They are my sisters. And your eyes steady out. Innocence starts pouring out of your eyes. It's a very, very simple thing. So in the eye, when you get your realization, you get a glint. Must have seen there's a shine. That is Vishnumaya. That is the Vishnumaya which shines through your eyes. And she's the one who makes you through the Maya of Vishnumaya. This glint in the eye you must have seen in people who are realized souls. And this glint in the eye is the one that makes you understand and feel the beauty and the power of sisterly, brotherly relationship. In the beginning of Sahaja Yoga, I found it impossible to establish this. So I said, let's try the Vishnumaya. And it worked. Actually, naturally we know this is wrong. We know that it is wrong. Naturally, you don't have to have a law for it. One lady came to America with her brother and she told me, when I had not come to America, it's a funny place. She said, I went to America and we wanted to stay in one room because they wanted to save money. They said, no, if you are brothers and sisters, you can't stay. I said, why? I mean, in India, if you are brother and sister, you can always stay. If you are not brother and sister, then of course you can stay, you don't stay together. The other way now, if you are brother and sister, you cannot stay in one room in a hotel under law. And it's a father and a daughter, you can't stay in one room. Absurd for us Indians, it's a shock. I said, but why? I just couldn't understand. Now I know what it is, that it has become now a law to that extent to us. It is absurd to have such a law. And as we have learned so many things from you about electricity, you also better learn from us certain thing about Vishnumaya's powers. There's no harm in learning something for the roots, because if the tree has gone wrong, it has to learn something very much essential from the roots, and that is it, the purity of relationship between brothers and sisters.
Mother, please. Remove all the guilt accumulated within me. Mother, I surrender to you. As I am the Spirit, by your grace, how can I be guilty? It's a great question to challenge our egos, our perceptions, to help us surrender. Mother, you who are Sri Vishnumaya, I surrender to you. Let's put our hands together and humbly thank Sri Mataji for the opportunity of this collective meditation, for the gift of Sahaja Yoga to humanity, and for guiding us and making us our channels for her divine work. Let's raise our kundalinis and put ourselves in a bandhan. Raise our kundalinis and put ourselves in a bandhan. Thank you everyone for your vibrational presence and have an absolutely fantastic day. We'll see you again tomorrow. Jai Shri Mataji.
अखिलं मधुरम्।